applications and kits in MSc Oil and Gas Management from Coventry University UK. Also BSc in Civil Engineering, Chemistry Ghana. PMP Project Management Institutes in USA. French 2 Acelos in UK. And an advanced diploma in project management, ICM. Finally, he holds application in management, managing safety, simply in the oil and gas industry. Without much ado, let's give a round of applause to Mr. Mwangi.
Thank you very much. Good still morning. We're here to basically talk about project management, but to link it to technology. Okay. Does it work? Yes, so we've been talking about project management, but to link it to technology. I believe your background is IT.
Yes.
Okay, both of you?
Yes.
Okay. Alright, that's fine. So do you have an idea about project? Who has an idea about project management? Who has done it as a course, apart from IT?
Kenya State.
Okay, what course?
IT.
Oh, IT. Is it computer science?
Yes. I did a level 200.
Introduction?
Yes, introduction.
Okay. So what do you know about it? Bottom line?
We came up, for example, like, project management has a lot of to do with time, cost, quality. Everything, human relations, communication skills, everything that has to do with everyday living. Okay. This man has to manage all, and so we have software to help with that.
Alright, that's fine. So you use a software to do that. Did they introduce you to MS Project?
Yes, Microsoft.
Microsoft.
Yeah, and now Gantt chart and all those things.
That's good. Well,
now it's lost. For my job, I do a lot of training, so I do this one. I don't forget my child. So, I have to be able to avoid accidents, and then some
that's fine. It's good. Once we go through this one, you realize that project is something everyone needs, you know, right? Basically the things that you're doing already. Okay, it's not anything different. So we're talking about project management and its impact on technology. So narrowing down to IT. Like she said, the name of my company is the Duane's Project Management Consult. Now the need for facilitator. And let's jump straight into it. Let's look at the technological world. See a little fancy, you have background in that area, so I don't have to talk much. You have the phones, the computers, the cameras, you know, the vehicles and all that. Now they are driven by a project. Now before I start, do you know that technology seeks to do things quicker and more efficiently? It's not the case. Unless fast backwards to 1,000 years. Your grandparents, your grannies, if they were looking for people, if you are in Kumasi, they want to go to Tamale, what would they do? They walk. if they want to achieve, want to pass on some information, they will send some people. They have to walk. So it could take 3 months, even a whole year, for them to come back with feedback. Technology. We invented vehicles. Mobile phones. Now even 20 years back or 50 years back, if you wanted to find a friend, look for a friend, you just go there and they'll tell you, oh, he just left the house. Or let me wait for him. You wait for like 20 minutes, you leave and you come back, oh, your friend just left. But now mobile phone can do all that. So technology is propelled by making things easier and getting things done quicker. Okay, so that's how come we have these things around your computers and everything, okay, and your laptops and everything. So that's the mentality, and I should be quick to say that it has a huge link with project management. Project management also seeks to facilitate, you know, timely achievement. Okay, you want to do things on time, do it quicker. Project management facilitates that. You want to do things more efficiently, project management facilitates that. So it has a connection, which we'll talk about later. So when we look at the technological world, it's basically driven by projects. The innovations, the phones and everything, they are all projects. So they give birth to innovations. Okay, so technology, basically, you apply some science in order to solve a problem. So, achieving something through a technical means. That's the definition of technology. Okay, so you use some technical means to achieve something, to solve a problem. And the world is full of problems. Okay, the world is full of problems. So we need to have enough technology to make sure we solve these problems. So we have innovations, they are all projects. The vehicle, the phones and all that, they are all projects. When we straight into project management, you understand why projects. But to be quick to talk about this, I'll say that they are all something you put timelines on. And everything you put a timeline on becomes a project. It seems from being an operation. Okay, operation and ongoing activities, repetitive. You know, you don't even know when they will end. But project is a definite timeline. You know exactly when it will end. So these innovations are all projects. The vehicles, your phones and your computer, your tablets, your laptops, they are all projects. Are we understanding this? So technology is basically driven by projects. Now, technology and project management have a strong connection. We'll talk about the connection. But it's very important for us to know why project management is needed in the technological world. But before that, you should know that project management has got its basis in IT. In IT, US, was able to become a super powerful country based on technology. There's something called techno-based planning. They used that during the World War II. Okay? And that made a huge difference. And even with Bridge 2, in the UK, they basically use Bridge 2. It's a methodology, project methodology. Even for that one, it started its journey in the IT environment, you know. And later, they made it generic, so everybody could use it for whatever they wanted to use it for. So IT and project management, they are strongly linked. IT and project management are strongly linked. Okay, so what it means is without project management, your IT, whatever you do with it, will be successful. Will be successful. Now, why is project management needed in the technological world? Because of complexity of today's product. Are they not complex? 10 years ago, 40 years ago, the laptops were very simple. Your phones, very, very simple phones. It's not the case. Your phones are very, very complex. We call them smart phones now. They can do a lot. So they are very, very complex. Now, if you don't pay much attention to your plug, if you don't pay much attention and monitor to your technical aspect and monitor properly, there will be a lot of mistakes. Do you know what happened to Note 7, Samsung Note 7? You can see that. It will be in your phone, it will be in your pocket, and it will start burning. So they have to call all of them back because of complexity. Products are becoming more and more complex. They're not simple anymore, they're becoming more and more complex. So you need to pay much attention to detail. You need to make sure every part is properly plugged. Every aspect is monitored. You check everything. Make sure every part is sorted out properly. If not, you have a lot of mistakes. Now let me bring this one down to your the simple things you do. You develop websites, database for other people. Now if you don't pay much attention to detail, there'll be a lot of mistakes. Because everything you do, you want to solve a problem. It's meant to fill some gap. It's for a purpose. Okay? So you have to make sure it's fit for that intended purpose. And to achieve that, something has to give. You need to think, plan, execute, monitor, control, and close the problem. So the things you do, they are projects, and you already do project management. Okay, just that we are not aware, and we don't do it properly. But once we get the awareness, we can do it properly. So we are here to ensure that we understand project management more. Now another thing is shorten product life cycles. Now the phones, if you still have to go into the phone industry, this one is basically Samsung videos. In the next few months, you see another brand, another model coming up. S, you have S8. Very soon you see S9. So the life cycles are getting very, very shorter. So if you also want, now we have smartphones. So if I'm also a phone manufacturer and I want to come out with a phone and thinking that, okay, I've got time, let me just relax a little bit. I bring it next 2 years. Next 2 years, you bring that phone, the trend is already gone. People are not interested in that type of phone anymore. So the life cycle of products are getting shorter and shorter. And what does that tell us? If you want to take advantage of a trend, you have to do it fast. So you can't afford to delay. So you always have to be working quickly, at a very quick pace. And how do you achieve that without having a lot of mistakes? Through project management. So project is very, very important in the technological world. And now, if you can't do that, you can't compete. So you see the competition, strong competition between Apple and Samsung. Because once they come up with a new product, Samsung also need to come up with another product to compete. Even in the bank industry, it happens. You always have to be introduced a lot of new products to get more customers. So in this competitive market, if you're able to do that, you can't survive. So I say this, in the next 5 to 10 years, you see a lot of businesses folding up. Those who do not pay much attention to project management, make sure they meet the timelines to achieve quality and customer satisfaction. Make sure they have a competitive price. They'll be folding up. So I'm not surprised to see companies like GTP struggling. Because these are in the global market. You are here, people from China can bring their product. So people, when we go there, we check, we talk about that one, what consumers look out for. One thing is price. So they won't say you want to be betrothed. So yes, your GTV is 70 Ghana cedis. The one from China is 50 Ghana cedis. So I want to be betrothed. So I want to buy that one. No, they won't do that. These are things. So the same thing when we bring it to the technological world, these are things you have to be watching out. Your price is very, very important. We're talking about that pretty shortly. So there's narrow product launch window, which has to do with the shortened product life cycle. So if you want to launch a product, the opportunity is very, very slim. So you need to act very, very fast. So when people wonder, okay, we want a website like this. Now if you can't do that, people are asking for it, you have to do it quickly. But very soon people wouldn't want that again. They want something different, upgrade and all that. So you also have to be upgrading yourself. Okay? You always have to be upgrading yourself. Keener competition. Very, very important. Keen competition. Because what you can't do, other people can do it. You don't have monopoly anymore. We are in perfect competition. If you can develop a website, you're not the only company that can develop a website. The other people can also develop a website. So what do consumers look out for? We will talk about that. Before that, we already talked about the connection. Technology is basically propelled by ease of use, making life what? Easy. That's the bottom line. We want to make life easy all the time. That's our point. We always have upgrades. We always have new products. Okay? So we always want to make life easy and achieve efficiency. This is not the case. That's how come, you know, we have the vehicles and all that. And very soon you realize that if someone needs a vehicle, whenever they take their legs off the brakes, it will stop automatically. The new Jaguars have that function. You know, if you are in traffic and you take your foot off the brake, the engine has to go off automatically. As soon as you step on it, it has to smart again. You know, that's a new technology. Because people don't want to be sparking or putting their foot on it all the time and all that. And people also want to save some fuel as well. So automatically, once you start, it will stop. Once you put your leg on it, it will start again. That's technology. So making life easy and achieving efficiency. Another thing they pay much attention or attach a lot of premium to is quality. It should, whatever you churn out should be fit for its intended. That's the definition of quality. Fit for its intended purpose or use or conformance to requirement or specification. So whatever you come up with, if you are developing a website, it should be fit for its intended purpose. So you need to basically understand what the purpose is. So sometimes you might be looking at something you might think is not quality. Other person look at it and say it's quality. If it's fitting that purpose, it's quality. So to really measure quality, the first thing you have to do is to identify the purpose. So the fonts, the big ones, we say Muhammad Ferry, people will take it and say, this is a bad font and throw it away. But is it serving the purpose? What's the purpose for Muhammad Ferry? Also of doing so, it's not a long battery life. And it's, if it's doing that, it's quality. It's not a smartphone, so it's not meant to do the WhatsApp and all that. So it's quality. Are we understanding this? So to measure quality, the first thing is to understand the purpose. Now let's look at what project management seeks to achieve. It facilitates timely completion. You want to do things quicker. That's how come we have technology. Project management also facilitates timely completion. We want to have some efficiency, achieve some efficiency in our budget and all that. Project management facilitates cost effectiveness. We place much emphasis on quality. Project management helps you to achieve quality and customer satisfaction. So there's a strong connection between technology and project management. So what it means is without project management, you whoever you want to come up with, who have issues. So technology is all about coming out of development, changing our product. It's not the case. Now without project management, it won't happen. you come out with a product of having issues. See Volkswagen, VW, don't be surprised to see Samsung, whole big company, Apple Group, whatever, Facebook, adhering to project management principles because they know they are very, very important, and without it, they can't achieve whatever they want to achieve. So project management really makes a difference in the technological world. It paves way for sound innovations. So I say this, guys, if you haven't got it, you've got problems. So if you want to develop your website, you want to come up with an application, if you haven't got project management, you have problems. Because customers will give you timelines. You have an application, but they'll give you 1 week, you finish it within a month. You delay, they might not come back to you again. Your price might be too high for them, okay? So without this, if you haven't got project management, you've got problems. You even have to stray away from the technological world to come up to a normal life. Without project management, you're nothing. Because you yourself, as a program, because you do project a lot. A program is a collection of projects. Okay? So you yourself, you do a lot of projects. You have to go for a funeral. You have to go for some party. You have to organize a party. You might have to organize an event. This event is it's a project. You might have to do something very, very important. Every day it's a project. Because you do things every day. It's not a day. You don't sleep. You do things on a daily basis. So your life in itself, it's a program because it constitutes a lot of project. So without project management, you see that you have lots of mistakes coming up. You see that, you know, there are a lot of delays. Your budget for the month of 1,000 Ghana will never be enough for you. They will pay you 1,005, will never be enough for you. Because you will come to your best. Go like, where are you? Then you go back. You come back the next day. You're wasting time. You're wasting money. So with project management, you become properly organized. It's very, very important. It's something everyone needs. It's a must-have. So this guy, we already know the answer to this one. What is that? That complementary essential one thing that we need to survive in today's competitive market. Know the answer. It's project management. I will break it down. So this guy thinks it's a must-have. He thinks it's making a difference in the technological world. Now before we move on to trying to understand what project management is and what a project is, you need to know the main things consumers look out for. The main things they look out for. Price. Time. Quality. Customer satisfaction. It's not the case. Now put yourself, make yourself a consumer, okay? And he is a supplier. He's actually manufacturing something for you. What are some of the things you'll be looking out for? Charlie, I've given you 2 weeks. You want him to meet that timeline. It's not the case. You are listening to the price. How much? That's the first thing most people ask. First question, how much? So you are thinking of the price, the time, and the quality. Is this something that will be fit for the purpose or will meet my specification or my expectation? Customer satisfaction. Are we understanding this? So it's the case. These are things they look out for. Now if you can't achieve all these things, you can't compete. Do you know why? Because you're not the only person who can do it. The other people can do it. So if you can't meet the timelines, it's got another person to turn to. It's got another company to turn to. Or if he gets a bad experience from you, he might not come back to you again. Return to your competitor. So once, if you're able to achieve this, trust me, you have a lot of jobs to do. People flooding with work, just like that. Because you meet, the price is good. It's competitive. Your time, you always need a timeline. Quality, whatever you give to them is fit for its intended purpose. So sometimes when people, so let's go back to developing a website. If you want to develop a website for a customer, the very first thing you do is to try to understand their requirements. That's what you do. It's not the case. Try to get their requirements. Okay? So you do what we call acceptance criteria. So you go to the customer. What will make you accept this website? Okay, I want this website which can have this. There should be a section for that talks about us. There should be a section that talks about services. I want a feature that can make people log in and book. So you listen to them. If you're able to do all that, you conform to the requirement or specification. And that's equal to quality. But if you can't do that, you haven't achieved quality. You want a section, whole section on services, you haven't done that. You open the website and go like, no, this is a bad website. It's not fit for use. It doesn't really give the results that we want. Okay? So if you can't do this, it will always come to you. And you have a good price, it will always come to you. It's something I've done and it's working. If you can do the same thing, it will work for you. That's what I tell a lot of entrepreneurs. If you want to start a business, you have to be looking at this. Price, time, quality, customer satisfaction. It should be very, very important to you. If you can't achieve them, you're out. And how do you achieve them? Through project management. Because you cannot come up with a competitive price. People are quoting $50 for their product and yours is 48. It's not possible. You might not make profit. So how do I achieve this? Coming up with a competitive price. People will bring their product, give them 2 weeks, they'll bring it in 3 weeks' time. But you want to bring it in 2 weeks' time. How do I achieve that? People will bring products and you realize that there are issues with them. But when you bring your product, it's on point. How do you achieve that? Something has to give. It doesn't happen just like that. You have to be doing something. Achieve that through project management. So we talk about project management. So it still comes back to this. If consumers look out for price, time, quality, customer satisfaction, and all these can be achieved through project management. If you haven't got it, you still have what? Problems. We all agree. If consumers look out for time, price, quality, customer satisfaction, all these can be achieved through project management, and you haven't got it, definitely you have what? Problems. Now let's do some lectures, small lecture, okay? Because it's important for us to understand project and project management. Yeah? Now what is project? So we all agree that project management is very, very important in the technological world. Without it, there will be problems. And people do it already. Apple, Samsung, VW, Benz, they all adhere to project management principle. Come go and Google it. Because they know without it, they can't compete. Technology is all about doing things quicker, making life easier, and doing things efficiently. It's not the case. Welcome to technology. And you can do all these things through project management. So every smart organization, and even the smart government, if you go to the UK, they use project management a lot. So they have something. Prince 2 came from the government, UK government. They invented Prince 2. So they use it for all their projects. So smart governments are using project management. Smart organizations are using project management. But in Ghana, very few people know about it. If you go to our public sectors, They don't use for the put together we do things anyhow.
We don't use Pokemon.
So it's about time we started using project management to achieve the desired result. We set budget and we exceeded by 600%. When we set budget exceeded by 600%, means the person who really set the budget, you don't even understand it. Because if you really know how to set budget, there's no way you can achieve it by 600%. And if you know what to do to adhere to the budget, there's no way you can exceed it by 600%. That's what's happening. So project management makes a difference, huge difference. So people with project management thinking, they do things differently. So I say this, project management will make you mad. So make you make a difference. Mad, make a difference. And difference makers are mad, it's not the case. I'm a cool as a difference maker. Is it the same as other people? He's different. So we people look at him and think you are some way. This guy is some way. We want independence. Maybe later, and this guy says we want it now. You are some way. He says it's possible. We can have that. You are some way. How is that possible? You are some way. So every difference maker is some way. So if you are boss and people don't see you to be some way, you are not an effective boss. Trust me. Because people, in our nature, we want to be left alone. We don't want people to give us pressure. You know, so there's a boss, he comes in, he doesn't give anyone pressure. Oh, are you working? Oh, can you finish? Oh, boss, I couldn't. Okay, that's okay. When can you finish? Oh, 2 days. Oh, that's okay. When we need it, the next 2 days. Oh, that's okay. Oh, you didn't report to work. Oh, that's okay. But a deeper boss, that wants to make a difference. If you don't turn up, he wants to know why. If you haven't finished, he wants to know why. He's always on your neck, checking up on you. You don't like that boss. But he's a difference maker. So you see your boss to be something to be mad. But to be a difference maker, you have to be making a difference. You have to be mad. Making a difference. You have to be mad to be a difference maker. So project management, it switches your mentality. Switches your mentality. If you want to go with the flow, there's no way you can achieve anything. Trust me. That's how come you have only few people making a difference. You can all, this one is for free. It's not the case. But look at the numbers. Let's organize the same event and tell them, oh, we are bringing Shatawale. You are bringing Abadam. You are bringing
Sakolia, mad.
Sakolia, ebony.
That is mad.
Tell me here. Huh? You need a bigger space, though.
Yeah.
This is too small for them. We should even go and do it at this venue. Because a lot of people will be coming. So many people, we love to be entertained just by that. Few people want to make a difference. That's why we have few people that are rich. So that mentality, want to bridge the gap between the rich and the poor, it will never happen. That's why even in the Bible says the poor will always be with us. They will always be with us. We can't change that mentality because only few people want to make a difference. The many people, they want to be left alone. They want to have their time, their space, their peace of mind. They don't want to be bothered and all that. Why should I be working on Saturday? I work from Monday to Friday. It's enough. Why should I wake up early? Why should I stay up late in the night working on something? I want to get some proposal. They don't want to be bothered. That's how the many men thinks. That's how they think. So to be a difference maker, let's go back to project. Definition of a project, any temporary endeavor is an effort, undertaking to create a unique product, service or result
is a project.
So anything you put a timeline, anything that has a start and a finish, to create some product, service or result is a project. We understand it. So people are agreed that we do a lot of projects, because there are a lot of things we put timelines on. And do you know it's very important to put timelines of anything you want to be, if you want to achieve more. If you don't want to achieve anything and relax, you can decide not to put a timeline on it. And whenever you put a timeline on something, you see people trying to work hard. You see some pressure. You see some people having that time awareness. But leave it like that. See people relaxing. But when should I bring this? Oh, anytime. Anytime, I'll bring it in 3 years' time. You'll say, oh, anytime. Because they will relax. I don't feel like doing it today, let me relax. Oh, tomorrow. We never get done. But whenever you put a timeline on this, on it, if they want to relax, they do this in timeline, Charlie. If you sleep, it won't happen. Like you, your project, there's a timeline on your project. Now don't put timeline on project. People will submit it in 4 years' time. But you know you have 6 months, we need 1 year to submit your project. And you know our mentality, we do the back-end loading. Whenever we are giving something, we don't do front-end loading, where we want everything right from the get-go. We will relax and wait till the end. Then we'll start, when pressure comes on us, then we are rushing. It's called back-end loading. You push everything to the end. So your project gives you 6 months. I have a lot of time. 6 months. For one project. So the first month, you relax. And second month, third month, fourth month, fifth month, they are now rushing. That's our mentality. And when it happens like that, you know what happens? Mistakes. Delays. You're going to beg your supervisor. I'll give you 1 month. I'll give you 6 months. Your mentality. So a good someone with project thinking knows you have to have that, do the front end loading. Plan everything right from the beginning and move. Okay, are we understanding? So anything you put a timeline on becomes a project. Let's say it's on a project, manufacture of a mobile phone, developing a website, developing an application, manufacturing a car, organizing an event. So this one is a project. This is not the case. There's a time that you start at 10, finish at 2. Activating dormant account. I'll tell you a little story with this one. A bank wanted to do this. I did not know it was a project. So they called me. I had an account with them. It was dormant. So they wanted to activate, to reactivate it. So they called me and said, Mr. Coordinator, you have an account with us. It's been a while since you used our account, so we wanted to know why and all that. So, okay, yeah, I haven't forgotten about that account. And I want to use it. Okay, so I don't even know the number, account number. So send me the account number. I'll deposit some money into it tomorrow. Okay, sir, we'll call you back. I don't know whether they'll call tomorrow. It's been like 2 years now. You know what happened? I think that the person forgot. Well, that was a project. They wanted to activate all dormant accounts. It's always better to keep the people you have, because you always want to get more. And you've got people, why not keep them? Couldn't keep me. They lost me. Now if they even go, I have a different account. A different account. Constructing a high-rise building. That's a project. So like a website application, all that. They are projects. It's not the case. When people give you jobs, website jobs, then they put timelines on it. When you want to do some application for some organization, don't they put timelines on it? A guy wanted to come up with an application for a school. Let's say you have to steal that in here. Parents would want to know what's actually happening with their kids at school. Okay? And parents are busy. So if they could have an application, even when they are working, when they are at work, they can just do connect and know how their kids are faring. So the grades and beyond know that they will just see it from their phone. Is it not the case? Is it not something that is good? Any parent would love to have something like that. So he came up with this nice, brilliant idea. So he approached some few schools. This is a very good idea. But we have to get this off the ground before the next semester starts. So now he hasn't done it. But it's a project. They gave you a time that before the next academic, whatever year or semester starts, time boxed. And to achieve that, you have to plan. And plan properly. You have to implement it. You have to check. Because you want to send something which will have a lot of issues. Because it's not seen as a project. You didn't make a timeline. And it still hasn't done it. I think. And once, when you go and tell people and give them your idea, or when you go and give people your idea, and you don't come back to them, they give the idea to a different person. Because they think it's very, very good, and they need it, and you can't do it for them, they will approach a different person. So probably the school has approached a different person to do it for them. And if that person can meet the timelines, that's a job. You have to manage the website. And every student you build it a little bit and give the money to you, and every month you see some payment. He still hasn't done it. Because it doesn't seem to be a project. Definition of project management. Application of knowledge. So you need to have some knowledge. So come here. Skills. You need to know about some tools and techniques. Okay. If you want to initiate a project, you have tools and techniques. One tool is benchmarking. You have to learn from other people. Best practices. So you learn. It's a tool and technique. So you need to know some of the tools and techniques. Some of them will come to you, will come readily to mind. Others you need to know about. You need to learn. Knowledge, some knowledge will come to you, others you need to learn. So you need to have some knowledge about whatever you are doing. You need to have some skills to be able to do it. You need to have tools and techniques to make it work. You apply that to your project activities in order to achieve your objectives. That's project management. So what it's saying is everything you are doing, apply knowledge. Apply some skills to it. You need some tools and techniques to be able to be successful. That act of planning, you can't take it away when you want to do a project. You have to plan. You have to organize things. There should be some leadership. You have to lead and control resources in order to achieve or exceed customers' expectations. So there's leadership in there. That's how come project management talks about leadership in human resource management. And now HR project management pushes for proper leadership. So the argument is project managers should be project leaders. We should stop calling them project managers. We should start calling them project leaders. Because it's kind of separates the technical from the soft. There's technical project management, there's soft project management. Okay? And most of the times you use the soft part. You might need a technical aspect, like your network diagrams, your Gantt chart, your calculating crashing, and all that. These are technical parts. You know, knowing when the project will pay itself back, understanding net present value, these are technical stuff. But these technical stuff can't be executed by technical people, the subject matter experts. But what really matters is people management. Proper monitoring, where you check time to time, you motivate the people, because without people, you can't achieve anything. You can have all the structure, all the systems, without proper leadership and proper motivation, it won't happen. So you focus more on that one. You need the technical aspect for the technical people to do that. Once you calculate some, do some MPV, even there's a software that can do that. You want to do network diagram, MS Project can do the network diagram for you. The Gantt MS Project can. So if I have someone who understands MS Project, that person can do it. I just have to take the result and act with it. So the monitoring part, that's why we need managers. Trust me. That is why we need managers. Because of monitoring. Every employer will go for a manager because they need people who will be monitoring. So if you're a manager, you're not monitoring, you're a bad manager. That's why you're there. So the same thing, if you have your own business and you yourself don't monitor, you're a bad manager yourself. Because you, to be able to manage your work, you need to monitor. And people do what is expected, not what is expected of them. If you think that, yeah, they are mature people, well, that's not my time. We're competent people. Mature people. I don't employ small boys. I want mature people, competent people. Employ them and leave them. Go and see what will happen. Without monitoring, you do anything. That's our nature. If you don't monitor us, we just do anything. And we'll do what will be checked. If you told me to bring a report to you every month, and I do it the first month, and I realize you haven't checked it, I made a mistake. I was like, mistake, when they see trouble. They didn't find it because no one actually checked it. Next month, I take my time and do, no one checked it. Even when you do these reports, no one checks it. And you are pressed for time. Let me just do anything and present it. It's just for formality. No one will just check it. And we'll get to a time, no one will do it. Have you brought your report off? You haven't done. Because they know it won't be checked. But when they know every month you check the reports, when they make mistakes, you read them, point to those mistakes, they will take time and do it, and try to do it every month. It's a mentality. If you told me to write my name every time I enter the organization, I write the first day, second day. If you told me when I'm leaving, I should sign out, write the time. Whereas if you don't check it, I'll stop. Have you understand this? So inspection is very important. The principle of inspection. It's very, very important. Now for inspection, everything, another thing is everything you for that principle of inspection, it saves a lot of time, it saves a lot of money. Someone can give you something. That principle of inspection is inspect. If you have that sense of inspection, if you have that attitude to inspect everything, you are achieving a lot. Trust me. Someone will give you something, it's in a package, you take it just like that. Do you realize that you get when you open it? Package. You're wasting time. You have to call the person, wasting money. But simple inspection could have avoided all these things. Probably you took the wrong thing. So you check, oh, Charlie, this is not mine. So, oh, let me go and check. Give you yours. You take it. We'll save you that time, that energy, that effort. Inspection is very, very important. They give you money, hand you money. But you won't check, you put in your pocket. You go back, tell it from soon. You go back, tell it how much did you give? Give you 5,000. No! It was 4,005. Not talking problems. A simple inspection is enough. I've learned to take all these things. Principle of inspection. Have that. It will save you a lot of time. It will save you a lot of money. Let's carry on. Now this is my definition of project management. Bottom line, it's all about you being more organized. It's all about you applying common what? Sense to whatever you do in order to achieve your objectives. And you need the tools and techniques as well, okay? But most of the time, you need common sense. And you trying to be more organized. Because with project management thinking, you don't want to be looking for things in the office. Where is it? No. Everything is properly organized. We know where we place everything. So if I'm looking for something, I know exactly where to go. With project management, we document properly.
with project management, we don't get into the middle of the whole project and start thinking, what do we do though? Everything is planned right from the get-go. So that is your roadmap. It's leading you every step of the way. Are we understanding this? Project management, you don't wait, yeah, that's happened. You know already. You even have an idea that this can happen and you have a mitigating strategy. It's the thinking. It's common sense. So if you align project management with the thinking of our grannies, grannies, they were very, very intelligent. So you want to understand your grandmother, why he will ask you, Charlie, Mrs. Singh, he will tell you something, you perfectly understand it, but he will ask you, hey, Asana Oka, Mrs. Singh, can you not lose it?
Oh,
that's crap. Usana, my heart beat. But that's a project management thinking. Because they want to be sure. Communication, one major component communication is feedback. So they want to be sure that, Charlie, because there's no communication, they have to send and the receiver has to understand it. So they want to ensure that you really have understood it. So they want to get feedback from you. And they will use feedback to correct. So if you say it and you think you're not saying the right thing, they will correct you and you go and say the right thing. Are we understanding this? And they will bring some picture, old picture, you never understand. Old pictures from 20 years back. They will have it. Some documentation, land papers, they will pull it for you. Receipt. But you don't give you a receipt. Where is the receipt? You can't find it. Very good project managers. Very good project managers. That's the thing. You need to be 4P. And these things are common sense. But we think that Chalomu Haibin, so go and take the receipt. The BR70, oh, he's a good person, but we don't need a receipt. Take the receipt. They will insist, take the receipt and bring it to me. So you want to be properly organized. You want to apply common sense. Everything you need to think. Use tools and techniques whatever you want to do in order to achieve your objectives. If you do these things, the pretty things you do, you realize actually it's been ages since I went like, look at you. Do you know, I'm not a magician. I'm not superhuman. But I write down everything I want to do. If I think it's very, very important to me, I will jot it down. So if you look at my phone, I have a to-do list in there. On my PC, I use MS Project. So when I sit down, I'll jot down everything I have to do before I start work. So now I get started. Enter the office. The first thing is pull my phone and see everything I've written down to be done today. I'll bring them. Okay, what do I have in my MS Project? I'll bring them. These are things that have to be done today. Then I'll prioritize them. What should be done first? Follow by. So when I sit down, I know exactly what I have to do. When you do that, you achieve more. Because sometimes you might be telling a joke to a friend when there's something very important to me. You might be laughing. You might be playing. You go to some office and they are playing you. Macho. It's macho. You go home. But there's work to be done. But do you know what they have forgotten? The boss has actually sent some of them to go and deliver a report. They have forgotten about it. Then the boss will go, I have been like, with you.
They are rushing.
You want to be properly organized, so you do not want to forget. So you write down everything that is very, very important to you. Throw more light on that. Now, what are some of the benefits? If you employ this in whatever you do, your IT, your things, your website development and all that, these are some of the things you are likely to get. High productivity, you achieve more. You can do a lot of applications in a year. Website, you can develop a lot for customers. website because you are properly organized. And you finish properly. You don't do the website for someone and you finish it and there are issues with it. So you have to take it back correctly. You take like 3 months. For the whole 3 months, you did only one website. But the first one, you didn't take your time to do it properly. So when you sent it, there were issues. We'll bring it back to you for you to correct. So you go here too, you did only two. The one who take pains, make sure there are no mistakes, check everything, you send it, and there are no problems. You go to the next one. So you realize that they need to do more. And your cost will also reduce. You satisfy your customer, you meet the timelines, reduce expenditure, quality services, product, result, good use of your resources, employee satisfaction and motivation. Because project management talks about human resource management. You have the project management thinking. You know that people are very, very important. So without people, you don't have anything. So you see how you motivate them. So it talks about motivation. And motivation is not all about money, is it? No? But that's what we think. We think motivation is all about money. We want pay rise. But motivation is not all about money. These are things that are meant to prevent dissatisfaction. Because at the point they won't motivate you anymore. If you are paid 500 Ghana cedis, you want them to raise it to 1,000 Ghana cedis, they give you 1,000 Ghana cedis, your needs will also go up. If you are living in a small bedroom, now you receive 1,000 Ghana cedis, right? Why shouldn't I go in for 2 bedrooms with, you know, or even buy a motor? Joining the trotter and all that, some which I want to buy a motor now. So your needs will also go up. So you realize that $1,000 is not enough for you. You need more money. So they have to pay you more all the time to get you motivated. You know? Your passion, self-actualization is the highest. If you look at the Maslow's hierarchy of needs, the highest is self physiological needs is at the bottom, and part of physiological needs is salary. You need salary for clothing and all that. Are we understanding this? So I always say this, you always have to follow your passion. Something you are passionate about, you don't get tired doing it. Passionate about what I do, I don't get tired doing it. I can stand here and talk for hours. I wouldn't feel the tiredness, the fatigue, because I love what I do. So if IT is what you love to do, do it. You never get tired doing it. But if it's something you don't like doing, then you have to stop. Find out what you like doing. Don't mind losing sleep because you want to achieve something. So you have to be passionate about whatever you want to do. Sound and effective communication. Because project manager talks about communication. And in communication, we realize that it's recipient focused. You need to focus on the recipient. So if you know the communication structure, how it's structured, one person, there's a sender who will try to encode. It means think. Encode means thinking. There's thinking in there. Whatever you want to pass on, you have to think through it. You encode. Then you send it through a medium to a recipient or a receiver. That receiver should be able to decode it. So that message, they should be able to understand it. If the recipient or receiver does not understand what has been passed on, it's all noise. You haven't communicated. So if I'm standing here, I'm French, understands French, I'm not communicating. I'm satisfying myself because I'm feeling French. But you don't understand. I'm not communicating. So I need to focus on you to ensure that you really understand me. That's communication. So bottom line, you should be understood. That's communication. It's not about fluency. Fluency plays a part. Grammar, they play a part. But if you can put proper grammar and they do not make sense, you haven't communicated.
Oh, he, you observe all the things and grammatical, whatever. Oh, he will go with that and all that, but what you pass on does not make sense.
You have not communicated. So bottom line in communication is you have to be understood.
So even when you write, don't write for yourself. Make sure whatever you write, the one you are writing for can read it. If they can't read it, you have to communicate it.
Are we understanding?
Because you've written for yourself, and communication is not about you.
It's about the recipient.
So Prajan will teach you about communication. If you really understand this mentality, this concept, you can do a lot of proposals with ease. Because proposals are basically suggestion. I want to suggest something to you. So you put yourself in the receiver, those your customer. Because you think, I'm saying this, does it make sense? If I have some 2 minutes, so let me define it properly. He must ask about the price. Is the price in the proposal? Because you are thinking. You have put yourself in their shoes. So realize that now you have a complete proposal, proper communication, communicated properly. So they read through your proposal, they understand you perfectly in communication. So project manager, someone who hasn't done communication management can even communicate properly without going through a whole course in communication management. People go do risk management for 4 years, people go do communication management for 4 years. People go and do human resource management for 4 years. But someone who has done project management understands how to motivate people. Respect. Gives you respect. It's not the case. Because if you're properly organized, they give you 4 days. They give you 4 days. Quality. According to your expectation. You get respect. I'll tell you a story. A job was given to someone who had to develop an application for an organization. So he called the executive, Charlie, I want this application, it's very, very important for my company. So get it done for me. We have to use it next month because it can save us a lot of cost. Okay, that's fine, we'll do it for you. He told the head of the department, Charlie, this is what we have to do, so get it done. Okay, sir. He forgot about it. So he came back 2 weeks' time. Okay, yes, this application done. Yeah. Let me talk to my head. Charlie, have you finished?
He was.
They did not do it because he forgot.
He forgot about it.
But when he was given the job, probably he had a call from the app, I don't know. Probably he had a call from the app. Charlie, your kid is sick, or you forget about it.
So he forgot.
And he never came back to mind. And he lost a lot of respect for him. It's because that person is no more. If you are well organized, you realize that it's something very, very important.